Bakery is a paid light mapper for Unity that produces much better lighting results than Unity's built-in one, and in a fraction of the time. It includes additional light mapping options that can really make materials pop while also being incredibly performant. Some caveats are that it requires an NVIDIA GPU, and RTX GPUs will see the greatest improvements in baking speed. It also costs $55, though it periodically goes on sale for half off. There's also a real-time preview for Bakery. If you have an RTX GPU, it allows you to preview your scene's final lighting directly in the scene view of the Unity editor, but with low-res textures. It is an additional paid asset, which also goes on sale for half off, and requires an RTX GPU. Being able to work in real time, to be able to preview the changes you make as you're making them, allows you to experiment much more and iterate much faster. Spending money on things that can make you do that are some of the greatest value purchases you can make as a 3D artist. At the end of the day, it allows you to make more creative decisions and ultimately be more creative, which is why I recommend the real-time preview so much. As for a detailed and technical rundown of the features Bakery brings to the table, it offers high-quality lighting using ray tracing and AI denoising. Both are supported by Unity's progressive Lightmapper, but Bakery produces higher quality results and allows for RT cores on RTX cards to be utilized, reducing bake times. It supports physically accurate lighting, but also options for stylization, like a mode that exclusively bakes ambient occlusion. It is really fast, a lot faster than Unity's light baking. Supports for more types of lights than Unity's default point and spot, such as cube map and IES lights. Supports backface GI for translucent materials like leaves. It can pack light maps tighter using X-Atlas, and it can bake different types of light maps that look much better than Unity's default. These different types of light maps are called directional light maps, which, instead of storing color values on each texel, store directional information. Unity's progressive light mapper also does this, using a technique called dominant direction, if directional is selected in the lighting window. It generates a single extra light map, but normal mapping can look faint and quite different compared to using real-time lighting. Bakery includes several other directional modes, including no directional data, only baking color, radiosity normal mapping, based off of the technique originally used for Half-Life 2 in the Source Engine, and baked normal maps, which takes normal maps into account while not generating an additional directional light map. However, the light mode that I am going to cover is spherical harmonics, or SH, which is based on how global illumination is handled in DICE's Frostbite engine, and it is the highest quality lighting mode that Bakery offers. In addition to a color HDR light map, it bakes three additional grayscale light maps representing directional information. It provides much better surface contrast and better representation of different colored lights coming from different directions. It can also give materials specular highlights, a feature that can normally only be achieved with real-time lighting. Note that to use these light maps, you must use a shader that supports it, such as Bakery's included PBR shader, which is a riff off of Unity standard. I will cover this using a more advanced shader than Unity's or Bakery's default, that allows for extra options such as exposure occlusion, which properly darkens surfaces and removes the Fresnel effect from places where it shouldn't be visible, which you can see in many Unity games if you look for it. Bakery packages these additional light maps with a script on build, however, this is blacklisted by VRChat, making the lighting look dark and washed out. It's ridiculous that this simple issue still hasn't been fixed all these years later, but if you're uploading worlds for VRChat, then I will cover a simple, easy to use, and relatively painless workaround. The in-editor tutorial will be covered in the next episode, which will be available exclusively to tutorial tier patrons and higher. Should have it up by the end of the month, so go subscribe to my Patreon if you want to see it. Bye.